I've been doing Google Ads for over 20 years, and this is the biggest mistake I've seen that kills your ad performance. When I fixed this for a Shopify client, it increased sales in Google Ads by 5 times overnight. I've seen inside hundreds of Google Ads accounts for Shopify businesses, and I'm dumbfounded at the number of brands that make this mistake. In this video, I'll show you how this problem may exist in your account, 3 options to fix it, and my favorite free fix, so you can possibly instantly increase sales. Anyone can do it. Imagine building a brick wall without checking if the wall is straight, the bricks are aligned, or how many bricks you need to build to your required height. You keep adding bricks thinking you're making progress, but without measuring and adjusting, you can't tell if you're building the wall well. Worse, you might overspend on extra materials, only to find some sections overbuilt and others neglected. In the end, you're left with an uneven, unstable wall that costs more than it should. If it's meant to support your house, you're setting yourself up for disaster when the whole thing cracks one day. This is the same mistake Shopify businesses are making with their Google Ads accounts all the time. Chances are, you're not tracking purchases as best as you could. So you don't know what keywords, ad groups, or ads are generating profit, leaving you with inaccurate results and wasted effort. This is like building the brick wall without a plan and not measuring the progress. There are 3 options to set up Google Ads conversion tracking in Shopify to fix this problem so that you can increase sales. Option 1, if you accurately track sales in Google Analytics, the quickest solution is to import your transactions as a conversion goal. I never use this method because the downsides are too great. View through conversions are not tracked. Also, Google Analytics uses a last click attribution across all channels, so you'll have ads contributing to a sale that get no recognition. Option 2, you can install Google and the YouTube app for Shopify. This is better than the Google Analytics import. It seems appealing to use the app for conversion tracking because you can click a few buttons to install the tracking, but conversion features are missing. Plus, purchase tracking is easy to set up yourself when you follow this guide. People still stuff up conversions with the app by doubling up purchase goals. The downside of the native app is it makes no use of conversion features like cart data that result in more data, like gross profit and more purchases tracked. Here's a comparison of how much better the tracking solution is in this tutorial compared to the native app for one of our Google Ads clients. Option 3, what I'm going to show you right now. This option uses the latest conversion features, which multiply Google Ads conversions 5 times overnight for this client. First step, create your conversion in Google Ads. Go to Google Ads, from the left, click Goals, click New Conversion Action, and Website. Add your Shopify domain. You have to click Scan. We don't care about the result, but have to do it to get to the next step. Click Add a Conversion Action manually. Use the following settings for your conversion. We'll find the steps linked in the description. Anytime you don't understand anything, there's a link to this tutorial with comprehensive instructions to help you with anything. Your purchase tag options will look something like this. Before you install the code though, I need to educate you about attribution because it's a setting that greatly affects the conversion data you see. If someone clicked on your Google Shopping ad, looked at a product but they didn't buy, they later return to the store by clicking on a branded search ad, then buy, would you attribute 100% of that purchase to the branded keyword? One attribution model does this and it's hurting your scale. A last click model gives 100% of the sale to the last interaction made by the customer. In this case, that branded search ad, not the shopping ad. It is favored by most amateur marketers because the last interaction is what got the customer over the line. The last click model ignores other touch points. I see no world where I'd use this model in Google Ads. Make sure your conversion tracking is the data-driven model. This is an automated attribution method where Google uses your historical data to build your own attribution model. By using this, different keywords, ads, and assets will get more attribution. Step 2. Edit the Google Ads conversion code for Shopify and add all features. In the details of the new conversion action, click Tag Setup. Click Install the tag yourself. You will see a Google tag and then a standard event code responsible for purchase tracking. that looks something like this. Copy the send-to variable somewhere for use soon. We're going to jazz up the standard purchase tracking code with more than sparkles and clone. We're putting the standard code under full anesthetic for a total body transformation. You don't need technical knowledge to do it. So copy this template code. See the link in the description of this video to get the full code you can copy and paste, which is on the Digital Darts website. Log into the admin section of your Shopify store. Go to Settings, Customer Events, click Add Custom Pixel, name it Google Ads Tracking, doesn't matter what you choose. Paste the template code. You'll now edit the top part of the code. Replace the AW Google conversion ID variable with your Google Ads conversion ID. Set the ID variables based on the ID structure of your shopping feed. To see what to select for the product ID and prefix product ID, log into Google Merchant Center. View the item ID column of your products. You may also find it helpful to log into the Shopify admin then cross-check a product's settings with Merchant Center. A tip that's helpful to understand the garble of numbers in the feed is to edit a product in the Shopify admin. The last number in the URL is the product ID. You can see if this value is used in the ID format of your feed. The tutorial in the description offers more help. Set your variables for Google's conversions with cart data. The AWX value is the send to variable from the Google conversion code. This value is inside the event snippet of the conversion. Replace YYY with your Google Merchant Center ID. You can get this from the very top right of your Merchant Center account. It is typically 7 to 9 digit number. Replace AU with the country associated with the feed. Replace EN with the language associated with the feed. Next step is to adjust the permission settings to suit your store and legal requirements. It varies, but stores in the EU are required to have a cookie compliance banner where users opt in to accept tracking. Such stores would select marketing and analytics. If there are no requirements, select not required for the most complete tracking accuracy. You should consult legal help to understand what tracking requirements are there for your pixel. Lastly, click save in Shopify and Connect to make the pixel live. You now have the best way to track purchases with the latest Google Ads conversion features. Step 3, test your conversion tracking. I haven't run into issues with code for Google Ads Shopify clients, but you probably want to test it to know what data is flowing through. Testing in Shopify's custom events is limited. What you can do is confirm the purchase tag fires and what data comes through. In the tutorial, I've given you some extra code you can use to test your conversion tracking so you can see inside your browser what gets sent to Google. For debugging, a great source is the diagnostics section. Another can be found by clicking on the conversion when clicking on web pages to see what pages are triggering the conversion and the conversion amount inside Google Ads. That's it. You have your brick wall plan in place and know how to measure progress. There are some optional steps of tracking, upsells, and implementing server-side tracking to really level up your data accuracy, but they're not must-haves for most Shopify brands. If you're curious, I've linked the full guide in the description. Now that your purchase tracking is great, how do you structure your Google Ads of your Shopify brand for growth? Watch this video and I'll show you the exact system I use to generate hundreds of millions of dollars for Shopify brands.